Good morning class. So today we will start the chapter 9, and the topic is multiplication of algebraic expression. Algebraic expressions. Polynomial by trinomial. For example, 3x multiplied with 2x minus 3y plus 5. So here it is a monomial and it is a trinomial. So if monomial has to multiply with the trinomial, it has to multiply with each and every term of trinomial. 3x into 2x minus 3x into 3y plus 3x into 5. Now this is first, and the second is 2 polynomials, for example 3x plus 2y multiplying with 9x minus 7y, then each term of this expression have to multiply with each and every term of this expression, this binomial. So first 3x will be multiplied with 9x minus 7y, and this plus sign comes here. Now 2y multiplied with 9x minus 7y. Now 3x will be multiplied with 9x first, minus sign. 3x is multiplied with 7y plus 2y multiplied with 9x minus 2y multiplied with 7y. 9 3 is 27, x square minus 21xy plus 9 2 is 18xy minus 13y square. So here we have a like term, so 27x square plus minus 3xy, and here minus sign is written because it comes with a greater value. So here is the multiplication of binomials. Now first note it down till here. on the third is multiplication of a binomial 2 trinomial. Now the example for this is 3x minus 2i. This is example of a binomial. Multiply with a trinomial, that is 9a minus 5b plus c. So each and every term should be multiplied with each and every term of this expression. So 3x first multiply with 9a minus 5b plus c, and here minus 2i, 9a minus 5b plus c. After that, 3x will be multiplied with each and every term. So 3x into 9a minus 3x into 5b plus 3x into c minus 2i multiplied with 9a minus 2i multiplied with 5b minus 2y multiplied with c. Now 9 is a 27. Ax minus 5 3 is a 15, bx plus 3 cx minus 18, ay minus 10, dy minus 2. So note it down. Now identity. An identity is an equality which is true for all values of variables. An identity is an equality which is true for all values of variable. The identity first is a plus b whole square, that is a square plus 2ab plus b square. It means we have to add the two terms, sum of first term and second term, the square of the sum of first term and second term is equals to first term is square of first term plus 2 into first term into second term plus square of b, second term. So here is the proof. A plus b whole square is equals to a plus b into a plus b. Both are binomials, so both will be multiplied with each other. Each and every term, a multiplied with a plus b plus b multiplied with a plus b. Now the bracket is again broken. A into a plus a into b plus b into a plus b into b. Now this is a square, this is a b, and this is a plus b square. A square plus 2ab plus b square is the final identity, that is the proof. Note it down. Identity second, that is a minus b whole square is equals to a square plus b square minus 2ab. So here is the proof. A minus b whole square is equals to a minus b into a minus b. That is a multiplied with a minus b multiplied with a minus b. So a has to multiply with each and every term of a minus b, that is a and b minus a into b minus b into a minus minus plus b square. So a square minus ab minus ba plus b square. And these two terms are like terms, so a square and that is 2ab plus b square, and here minus minus minus. Note it down. Now we will go to the next identity, that is third identity. Third identity is in bracket a plus b, in other bracket a minus b, is equals to a square minus b square. So the proof a plus b, a minus b. A multiplied with a minus b and plus b multiplied with a minus b. Now a multiplied with each term plus b multiplied with a minus b into a square minus ab plus ba plus b square. Cancel out minus ab plus ap. So a square plus a square minus b square is the final identity.
Note it down.
Now fourth identity is plus a x plus b plus 2 x multiplied with x plus b plus a multiplied with x plus b. Now x into x plus x into b plus a into x plus a into. Now here x square and this is dx and this is c ax plus a. Here you all can see here x is the common literal or variable, so it can be written as like this.
Note it down.
Now class, here we all have done all the concepts, and now in the from the next class we will do some questions of exercise as well as example and some questions from the outside of the book. Okay, so thank you class, it's all over for today. Thank you.